They couple to each other strongly enough so that hundreds, even thousands, can flash together in the same split second. There's a great simulation of this by Nikki Case. You start with individual fireflies just doing their thing, and then you can turn on the interaction between them. Now, in the Kuramoto model, this would mean every firefly has an effect on every other one. But in this simulation, a firefly is only affected by its neighbors. If it sees a flash close by, it nudges its internal clock forward a little bit, so it'll flash sooner than it would have otherwise. Now, what's remarkable about this is even though the interactions are small and close range, over time you can see waves traveling through all the fireflies, and eventually, they're all flashing at once.
Like you might think, if you increase the coupling,
air currents. When he separated the clocks, the synchrony would disappear, their times drifting apart, but when he brought them back together, the synchrony returned. Huygens realized the two any other oscillator, as a point on a circle. This shows its phase, that is, what part of the cycle it's in. So you could call the rightmost point of the pendulum 0 degrees, and then the leftmost point is 180 degrees. And as the pendulum oscillates back and forth, the point goes around the circle. The higher the frequency of the oscillator, the faster that point goes around. So this represents two metronomes with different frequencies, and this represents two metronomes with the same frequency, but completely out of phase. When the metronomes are synchronized in phase, their dots go around the circle together. We can use this depiction to illustrate a mathematical model for the synchronizing behavior we've been looking at. It's called the Kuramoto model. It says the rate each dot goes around the circle equals its natural frequency plus some amount related to how far it is from all the other dots. Now, the size of this term is determined by the coupling strength.
Nails are going from a low entropy state of looking all disorganized to a higher entropy state of looking organized. Now, if you thought that entropy was disorder, you aren't alone. If you ask most people which jar has less entropy, they'll probably tell you that the one that's nicely ordered has less entropy.
Three, two, one, go! 春去春去赛过，忘情故事洒脱。为你朝思夕月的要寻到结果，你说到底为什么？都是我的错，都把爱情讲得太。
Absolutely spectacular. This is fantastic. A couple of people had asked at the end of the last video what happens if you interrupt the beam on this thing. Because this isn't a Brewster laser tube, what will happen is the beam will dim, but we still have a laser beam. So this is very, very easy to align when it comes to setting this thing up. It doesn't take much to ruin the cue of this cavity. If I take a very clean glass microscope slide and insert it into the beam, we can see that the bright beam goes out and we're just left with the output from the helium neon laser.